In this tutorial, I will tell you some miscellaneous information regarding this strategy. I will start with the system information. In contrast with the one tool, where all system information are available by means of system variables, here in C-Suite only few, about 20, while other system information are available through the system function block sysread and syswrite. There is a list of information that we can read and write, and there is a correspondent number. So, for example, to read the operating system version, we have to read the parameter 14. So we have to use a sysread where param is 14. The value in the output is somehow the operating system version. Now I show you an example. This is a project based on the project template. Here are some sysread function block reading some sys information. One of them is the operating system version, the parameter 14. You can see that this project doesn't use a constant here, but uses define words like this. For example, the sysparam OS version is 14. This one. Next, time management. In one tool, there is a bunch of system variables containing time and date. In C-Suite, there is a specific block for that. It returns time and date, and something similar to change time and date. In this slide, I used variables which names is the same of one tool system variables, but you can use a variable with any name. Here there is an example. So this block returns the current time and date, and these blocks are used to change time and date. This slide contains the most important information regarding the syntax of the ST structured text language. For this reason, I recommend you to study this very well. I also remind you that the ST is one of the 4-5 programming languages of the standard IEC 61131. For this reason, internet is plenty of tutorials and other information regarding it. Cast basically means convert. This is something typical for all programming languages because they support several data types, while function and function block typically accept and return a specific data type. So often is necessary to convert a value into another one. In this example, we have a strategy implementing the calculation of the area of a circle where the radius is expressed as real, while the area is expressed as int. So at the end of the formula, we have to convert this value that is real into an int compatible with the data type of area. Another typical use is here for timers, where the preset time is a time data type, while application typically have the time expressed in seconds. And since time basically is a time period expressed in milliseconds, we have to multiply by 1000 and then convert the result into a time. If you know one tool, probably you noticed that over the blocks there aren't the numbers. So the question you may have is, what is the block execution order? In C-Suite, the order depends on the position of the blocks on the POW, on the page. The order is top to bottom, and if the blocks are at the same level, from left to right. And then, if the blocks are connected, depend on the connection of the input and the output. Let's see an example. I place some blocks. So, what is the execution order of these blocks? We can show the order with this menu, the context menu execution order, show execution order. In this version there is a small issue for which the number is not shown at this moment. We have to select also the other menu, manual definition. Here is the order. So these two blocks are at the same level, so the system will execute first the one at the left and then the right, 4 and 5, and below there is this one, number 6. The other two are at the same level, so 7 and 8. The order changes if I connect them. So if I connect the output of this block to this, the input of this, the output of this to the input of this, the output to the input, the output to the input. So what is the order? So I have to unselect this and reselect. Here is the new order. The first block of the chain is this one, 4, and then 5. The output is connected to the input of this, so 6, 7, and 8. And I believe that this is the order that you expect. So this respects the general rule for which if a block returns a value used by another block, that block should be executed before. Well, it is possible to change or to force a given sequence. For example, if I want to execute this block after this one, I can select it, right click, execution order, renumbering special, before, after, or just another option. For example, after next selection, so after this. So this is number 6, and after there is that one. So it is possible to change the order, but in any case it's not recommended. It's better to use the default order, this one. Well, what I told you regards the blocks of a given POW, given page, but what about the POWs in a given application? So the POW are executed from top to bottom, like in one tool, according to the sequence here in the Solution Explorer. For example, if I create new POWs, execution order will be from top, so this one, to bottom, this one. You can easily change the sequence with a simple drag and drop. This one, drag and drop at the end. Well, this is all regarding the block execution order. Next, how to create a region. It is possible to surround blocks with a region. A region basically is a rect with a title. Enter to control with this special area. If you do something from this area, that operation will be extended to all objects inside the region. For example, if I click the region here and then move, I will move only the region. If I move from here, it will move all the objects. If I delete this, it will delete also all objects inside. If I copy from here or duplicate, it will duplicate all the objects inside. So the regions are very used in all our all Karel standard application, core application, demo application, and so on. Here are some examples. This is a region. Also this one is a region, also this one, and so on. I have already shown you the next two functions in the previous tutorial. In an STPOW you can easily place statements with a simple drag and drop from the toolbox. And then there is the quick declaration. For example, here is the toolbox with the statements, drag and drop. The system shows the template, so just replace the placeholder with the variables, statements, expression, whatever else. So this is very convenient, in particular for beginners who doesn't know yet the syntax of the language. The other is the quick declaration. It is something available in the global variables as well as in the local variables. Right click the background, quick declaration. Okay. Can specify a prefix, a suffix, okay, fill in all other properties, then OK, and quickly you can create similar variables. Next, password. This regards somehow the intellectual property, so this allows to prevent that someone open a PO. Example. Let's suppose that this is your project and you have to send it to Karel to support, for example, but you don't want that we are able to open this PO. Well, you can right click, protect with a password. Okay, well, I won't do it. So, when a PO is protected, it will be possible to use it, build a solution using it, but won't be possible to open it without the password. The next function is not strategic, but it is very convenient in order to save space in the page and sometimes also to increase the readability of the code. This function allows to replace not blocks like this with a connection where the property is negation is set to true. So the circle is the evidence that there is a not in the middle, so the incoming value is negated before to enter, let's say, in the next block. So the strategy is much more compact now. Next, variable and input parameter must be connected. So, it states that I can't leave variables like this, as well input like this, unconnected. Here is. Next point, some blocks are extensible. At the moment, only the plus and the multiplication and or support this feature. So, it states that it is possible to double click the block, select the number of inputs, and then OK. It works also with the OR, double click with only 5, and here is. So there aren't the specific blocks for OR with 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on input. Just double click and select the number of inputs. Next, some blocks support the overload. At the moment, the arithmetic blocks functions and the comparator functions. You notice that some blocks are able to read and write from to a specific data type. Other, like the add, support the overload, that is, are able to read write into any of integer and real value. In this example, we have the add that reads real value, so it will return a real value. But we can use the same block with variable. For example, this is a integer variable. So integer, and the output will be integer. Next, comments. Comments in ST starts with this marker, parentheses star and star parentheses, not yet the double slash. We saw this in the first exercise. Well, here is, do you remember? Also, this function is very convenient how to pan the page or pan the poise. Right click the mouse and move. I'm clicking the right button and then move without using scroll bars. Right click and move. Next, how to replace a block. Simple. If you have, for example, to replace the head with a division, for example, you can right click block selector or simpler double click, select the new block from this grid as well as with the filter, double click, and this is the result. It is possible to open several instances of Strategy Mask and other editors. Probably noticed here I have already two C-strategy. One with this solution, Chiller, and the other with the exercise 2 Chiller. This is very convenient, for example, if you want to check how you develop a given strategy in a project while you are working into another project. At the moment, it is not possible to copy object from, for example, some blocks from a C strategy to another, but in the future it will be possible. Also next features are not strategic, so I can show you very quickly. If you type a letter, for example C, you can select the next object starting with the C. The Alt can pan and arrows can pan the page, control you can select the object and arrows the object in that direction, and so on. The next and last point of miscellaneous reminds you that the retained memory has a limited number of write cycles, at least 100,000, exactly like the OneTool Pico platform for the retained memory. The difference is that in OneTool there is a specific block that are able to write in the permanent memory, while in C-Suite is not so. So it is possible to do something like this, change the memory of comp1 from not retain to retain, without receiving errors, any error. So in some cases it's very convenient, in other cases like this could be an issue. It is possible to do something even worse, like this. A connection between variables like this means is an assignment. When the value on the left changes, the value is written into the variable on the right. In this case, every time the temperature changes, that value is written into this variable. Since typically the temperature changes very often, this variable retain will be written very often, and so the limit of 100,000 times will be reached maybe soon, after some days or some weeks. And remember that it is not possible to replace by yourself the memory, so you have to send back to Karel. Well, that's all regarding the miscellaneous. I remind you that in the quick reference there are other interesting, very interesting information. That's all. Thank you for watching.